So welcome to the very first episode of the lesson series. Just like the mega tutorial, I am going to start things off by mentioning the guardian armor and defender weapons, because I feel like this is what beginners will get drawn to, like I did, because I also was in the beginning like, oh what? These weapons have so much more damage, they cost so much less to craft, and you know, I get so much more defense and HP and skills and everything. Who in the right mind wouldn't use this? And I feel like that's the trap that beginners fall into. So just to get this straight, you know, right off the gate, the guardian armor set and defender weapons are not meant for beginners. The reason they are there is for returning players, or for those of you who just want to rush their way into the Iceborne content. So that's why they're so overpowered. You can still use them. There's no rule or anything that says that you can't, but you won't be getting the true hunting experience, because you just, you know, plow through the storyline. Monster Hunter is intended to be sort of a grindy, player skill heavy kind of game, with a proper progression to go through. So if you decide to use the armor and weapons regardless, don't complain about how the game is too easy and, you know, there's no challenge. So then, should you use it? I would say no, just like all the hunters in the community, but honestly, it still really is up to you in the end. If you have no care for the progression and just want to see what the game is like, and you know, just go through the story really quickly, then sure, by all means. Just know that if you end up in Iceborne, the armor and the weapon will be rendered obsolete, and you have to start grinding for monster parts to craft the Iceborne armor and weapons, and you know, start having to rely on your player skill anyway. So yeah, but for those of you that want a challenge, you know, you want to experience the game how it was meant to be experienced, then treat the armor set and the weapons like they don't exist, because they are not for you. I mean, specifically the guardian armor and the defender weapons, of course. So go out there, learn about the monsters, learn about their habits, learn about your weapon and the game's mechanics, and build your character from the ground up. But that's enough rambling about this topic. This is a video game after all, so you know, just do whatever helps you have the most fun with it. That wraps up lesson 1. And I'll see you in lesson 2, where I get into the 14 available weapons. See you guys there, and as always, happy hunting, hunters!